one God. لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the best of stories from the Quran. And today we have a story that must be told, especially for the brothers and the sisters who live in Christian societies. They must share that story with the Christians. They must share it with them from the Quran, which is the story of Maryam and the birth of Isa alayhi salam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Maryam, when she became an orphan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined and ordained for Zakaria alayhi salam, the prophet of the time, the father of John the Baptist, Yahya alayhi salam, to take custody of her, to be her guardian. He placed Maryam alayhi salam in the house of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the angels to call upon Maryam, telling her, وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ يَا مَرْيَمُ قُنُتِي لِرَبِّكِ وَاسْجُدِي وَارْكَعِي مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. Basically, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Maryam that he has chosen her for a mission that no other woman would carry but her, will take on that responsibility but her until the day of resurrection. The mission is having a child without a father. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is not a societal norm. This is something that is odd. It's a fitna. It's the test for Maryam. It's a hardship in a way for her. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is directing her to the tools with which we can obtain patience that will help us with the experience of hardships. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Maryam alayha salam found herself isolated from the people in the house of Allah, and she actually placed a barrier between her and them, and she started praying and worshipping and praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
واذكر في الكتاب مريم إذ انتبذت من أهلها مكانا شرقيا فاتخذت من دونهم حجابا فأرسلنا إليها روحنا فتمثل لها بشرا سويا.
And mention in the book, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Maryam, when she withdrawn from her people to a place to the east, and she devoted herself to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we sent to her, then we sent to her our spirit Jibril alayhi salam, and he appeared to her in a form of a human being. Brothers and sisters in Islam, here is the reaction of a righteous woman, a righteous girl. As soon as she saw a man in her presence, she immediately sought refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
قالت إني أعوذ بالرحمن منك إن كنت تقيا.
She said, I seek refuge with the most merciful, Ar-Rahman, if you truly know what that means. If you truly know that if I'm under the protection of Allah, the most merciful, you cannot harm me. If you have taqwa, you cannot harm me. Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, who appeared in a form of a man to her, he revealed to her the news that he is the messenger of Allah and he is there to basically be the means, the tools with which she will become pregnant.
قال إنما أنا رسول ربك لأهب لك غلاما زكيا.
I'm the messenger of Allah to you and I'm here to be the reason you will be conceiving a purified child.
قالت أنى يكون لي غلام ولم يمسسني بشر ولم أك بغيا.
She said, how can I have a baby when no man touched me nor I am unchaste woman. سيدنا جبريل عليه السلام told her that all he has to do is to blow in her sleeves where the breath will reach to her private part without even touching her and she will then conceive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
ومريم ابنة عمران التي أحصنت فرجها فنفخنا فيه من روحنا.
And Maryam, the daughter of Imran, who was a chaste woman, and we breathed into her private part, and she conceived a child. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Maryam, alayhi salam, became pregnant with Isa, Jesus, alayhi salam, without a man touching her, without intercourse. That is the word or the verb. Brothers and sisters in Islam, she conceived and she withdrawn from the people.
فَحَمَلَتْهُ فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَى جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتْ قبل هذا وكنت نسيا منسيا.
You have to imagine, brothers and sisters in Islam, the feeling, the emotions of a chaste woman who was so known amongst her people to be the worshipper, the righteous girl in a community, in a society at the time that would shun adultery and having a child out of a wedlock. All of these thoughts were going through her when she is becoming pregnant, when she is conceiving, and when her womb is growing as a pregnant woman. And when the delivery, the pains of delivery approached her while she was under a trunk of a palm tree, she wished that she is dead. She wished that she is a forgotten thing. She is worried, brothers and sisters in Islam, about what to come. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the quality of a shy woman, a chaste woman. Some people, brothers and sisters in Islam, accuse Maryam of adultery. وبكفرهم وقولهم على مريم بهتانا عظيما. They are still till this very day accuse Maryam of adultery, but the Quran praises Maryam. ومريم ابنة عمران التي أحصنت فرجها. She was a chaste woman. She was concerned about facing her people. But again, brothers and sisters in Islam, never despair from the mercy of Allah. Allah will always deliver you if you do His work.
فناداها من تحتها ألا تحزني قد جعل ربك تحتك سريا وهزي إليك بجذع النخلة تساقط عليك رطبا جنيا فكلي واشربي وقري عينا فإما ترين من البشر أحدا فقولي إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا.
Fear not, grieve not, Maryam. Grieve not. For water, here is a running stream. Eat, here is ripe dates. All you have to do is just touch, shake the trunk of a balm tree. For the people, vow that you are fasting. Tell them that you are fasting. Not fasting from food and drink, no. You are fasting from speaking. Let us defend you, Maryam. Maryam, let us defend you. We'll take care of you. We'll take care of you. Whenever they confront you with any allegations, just tell them that I'm fasting. I'm not going to speak.
فحملت فأتت به قومها تحمله.
She came to her people carrying the baby Jesus, Isa alayhi salam, in her hands. Let's find out the reaction of Bani Israel to Maryam coming with a baby carried on her chest. What they will say to her and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver Maryam from their allegation. Let's take a short break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord of all the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.
Each day, we'll take one step closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the Qur'an, to our way of life. Each day, we will explore the acts of worship that we do, and we will find out how they relate to our hearts, how they impact our souls, how they help us understand the reality of existence. All of this and much more in our show, One Step Closer. All of you are invited to join us. Share your stories, share your aspirations, share your love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll be happy to have you on board. Join us in One Step Closer.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we are sharing with you today the story of the birth of Isa alayhi salam, the story of Maryam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, right now Maryam alayhi salam is carrying Isa alayhi salam, and she is to face her people.
فأتت به قومها تحمله.
She brought him, carrying him to her people. Look at the reaction of the children of Israel.
قالوا يا مريم لقد جئت شيئا فريا.
Oh Maryam, oh Mary, What an awful thing. You Mary, having a child without being married.
Ya ukhta Harun,
you are from the offspring of Aaron, the brother of Musa alayhi salam.
Ma kana abuki imra'a saw,
your father Imran, a righteous man.
Wama kanat ummuki baghiya,
and your mother Hannah, she was a chaste woman, she was a good woman. Remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in some of the wording, by the way, was Isa, the one who spoke earlier, or Jibreel, told her, don't even speak. Don't even defend yourself. Just tell them that you do not speak. Maryam, alayha salam, trusting what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her through Jibreel or Isa, based on the tafsir of our righteous predecessors.
فأشارت إليه.
She pointed at the infant, at the baby. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the first words came out of the mouth of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Listen, this message has to be shared with the Christians. You are living in the Western world, brothers and sisters in Islam, for this, to share this message with them. Look what he said. صلى الله عليه وسلم
قال إني عبد الله.
يا الله, the first words came out of the mouth of Isa عليه السلام, I am the slave of Allah, I am the servant of Allah, not the son, not one of three, not Lord, not God. It's like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, don't make anything out of me.
إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب.
He given me the book, الإنجيل.
وجعلني نبيا.
Prophet Isa is telling them, and he's an infant by the way, baby. He spoke as an infant, and he made me a prophet.
وبرم وجعلني نبيا. وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا.
Not only this, I have to do acts of worship too like you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded me to establish the salah, to pray to him, والزكاة, and to pay the zakah as long as I live.
وبرًا بوالدتي,
and I will be dutiful and kind to my mother.
ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا,
and he did not make me an oppressor.
والسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا,
and peace be upon me the day I was born, the day I shall die, and the day that I shall be resurrected again. Look.
ذلك عيسى بن مريم.
This is Isa, the son of Maryam. Brothers and sisters in Islam.
قول الحق الذي فيه يمترون.
This is the speech, the true speech, the true talk. This is the true story of Isa عليه السلام. They are debating about.
ما كان لله أن يتخذ من ولد سبحانه.
It is not befitting for Allah to take a son. Glory be to him. He does not need a son.
إذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون.
When he wanted something to be, all what he does be and it will be. And here is what Prophet Isa told his people.
وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُوهُ.
Isa is telling their people that, his people that, Allah is my Lord and your Lord, worship him.
ذَلِكَ هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ.
This is the straight path. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this story has to be shared with the Christians. Don't compromise it. I recall Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, when he migrated, he was the emir of the immigrants to Abyssinia, and he was placed on the spot when Amr ibn al-As and Abdullah ibn Abi Rabi'ah, the delegation of Quraysh, to the Negus, to Najashi, in order to bring the immigrants to Abyssinia back, in order to punish them again. He stood, Amr ibn al-As, in front of the Negus, and he told him, the Muslims are saying that Isa is a slave. Isa is not a lord. Isa is not what you believe as Christians. The Negus called the Muslims back, and he wanted to know what Islam, what the Quran, what the revelation says about Prophet Isa alayhi salam. You know, brothers and sisters in Islam, the consequences of the presentation of Ja'far would lead to the Muslims being sacked again, being brought back again to the Quraishi to be persecuted and punished. That is the consequences, that is the fear. The Muslims got together and they did shura, counseling. What should we tell him? What should we say about Prophet Isa alayhi salam to that devoted Christian? You know what they said? We only say what Allah said and what the Messenger said. We'll tell him what's in the Quran. Don't compromise this message, brothers and sisters in Islam. Sayyidina Ja'far radiyallahu anhu stood in front of the Negus, the Najashi, and he recited the verses that I recited in this episode to you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the leader of Abyssinia became a Muslim because Ja'far did not compromise the message. Don't compromise the message of Islam, brothers and sisters in Islam. Don't. Christians deserve the truth to be told to them. Don't shy away from the truth. Tell it nicely. Say it nicely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you in the Quran to be kind to the people of the book. وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. Do not dispute with the people of the book except in the kindest manner possible. True. But don't compromise the message. They deserve the truth. Tell it to them. Tell it to them, brothers and sisters in Islam, that Isa alayhi salam is the slave of Allah, is the prophet of Allah, is the messenger of Allah. And brothers and sisters in Islam, we love Isa so much. His status in Islam is so high. And when the Christians believe that he is the messenger of Allah, he is the prophet of Allah, that will lead them to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and believing in Muhammad, the final messenger who was sent to humanity, to the Jews and to the Christians. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we have a message for the Christians that we need to share with them. That message is so clear. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Those who say that Allah is the Messiah are disbelievers. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحُ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبَّكُمْ. And the Messiah told the children of Israel, worship Allah, your Lord and my Lord. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever associates someone in worship with Allah, Allah will make Jannah haram for him. Brothers and sisters in Islam, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةَ. Those who pray in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost are not Muslims, are disbelievers. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the message that we have. It has to be told nicely so. You have to tell it in a nice way. Share it with them in a nice way. As a matter of fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us analogy in sharing that message with the people of the book. إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمْ خَلَقَهُ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثم قال له كن فيكون. If you're saying that Isa is the son of Allah because he was created without a father, what about Adam? He did not have a father nor a mother. Adam is more deserving to be the son of Allah than Isa alayhi salam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to close with this. The story that I shared with you tonight, the birth of Isa, according to the account of the Quran, you will be shocked to find out that it is not in the Torah. It is not in the New Testament. It is not. The fact that Jesus spoke, Isa alayhi salam spoke in the credo is not there. Check it out. It's not there. I mean, it's not there. I tell you that for a fact. Even so, it's so supporting to the belief that he is the son or he is God. How many infants speak out there as they are in the credo? Not too many. But here's the question. If I tell you my infant spoke yesterday, for example, what will you ask me? What did he say? What did he say as an infant in the cradle? You see, what Isa alayhi salam said is so refuting to the allegations and to all the false distorted beliefs that the non-Muslims made out of him. He said, Inni Abdullah, I am the servant of Allah. I am the slave of Allah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, don't miss the next episode of the best of stories. I would like to talk to you about the crucifixion, the so-called crucifixion of Isa alayhi salam, according to the Quran. Again, this message has to be shared with the Christians, but in the kindest manner possible, I stress. Till the next episode of the best of stories, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf. And I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.